Hi, my name is Margot Wijnen. I'm a professor of process and energy systems engineering at Delft University of Technology, and I'm the founding and scientific director of the Next Generation Infrastructures Research Program. It's a great pleasure to welcome you to part two of the course on next generation infrastructures. Imagine how your life would be without electricity to power the devices you use at home and in the office, without reliable drinking water from the tap, without all-weather roads, trains, or air traffic, without your mobile phone, or without internet access. Those of you who have participated in Next Generation Infrastructures Part 1 know that the provision of reliable and affordable infrastructure services is not a given. Let's have a look at some of the facts. 1 billion people lack access to safe and all-weather roads. 4 billion people are without modern communication facilities. 790 million people have no access to safe water. 2.6 billion people lack access to affordable, secure, and clean energy services for cooking, heating, and productive uses. 1.3 billion people lack access to electricity, and 1 billion more depend on unreliable power grids. Smoke from inefficient cooking, lighting, and heating devices kills almost 2 million people every year, mainly women and children. And more than 3.4 million people die each year from water, sanitation, and hygiene-related causes. And nearly all those deaths, 99%, occur in the developing world. Let it be evident that the world needs more infrastructure and better infrastructure services so that all the world's citizens can enjoy infrastructure-related benefits. The McKinsey Global Institute estimates that $57 trillion in infrastructure investment will be required between now and 2030, simply to keep up with projected global GDP growth. This figure includes the infrastructure investment required for transport, such as road, rail, ports, airports, electrical power, water, and telecommunications. It is a dazzling figure, especially when realizing that the $57 trillion required investment is more than the estimated value of today's worldwide infrastructure. Even then, this amount would not be sufficient to address major backlogs and deficiencies in infrastructure maintenance and renewal, or to meet the broader development goals of emerging economies. Outdated or inadequate infrastructure and the resulting congestion, power outages, and lack of access to safe water and roads is a global concern, and that includes advanced economies like Germany and the US. The estimated five-year investment need in the USA alone amounts to over $2 trillion. Moreover, the task of financing the world's infrastructure needs is even more challenging and the costs even more astronomical because of the evident necessity of making infrastructure resilient to climate change and less harmful to the natural environment. All over the world, national and municipal governments are involved in developing and managing infrastructure systems with a focus on securing a livable environment for their citizens and improving the conditions for economic growth while protecting the natural environment. They have to, as we are becoming increasingly dependent on a secure, uninterrupted, and affordable supply of energy, water, transport, telecommunication, and information services. Huge investments are needed. But how can we increase the effectiveness and efficiencies of these investments? Given the scarcity of resources, the challenge can be summarized as the factor 8 question. Is it possible to imagine infrastructure systems that can meet the needs of twice today's population with half today's resources while providing twice the livability. In this course, we explore four topical themes in infrastructure development. First, the challenge of developing flexible infrastructures. Decisions to invest in new infrastructure or in new infrastructure capacity cast a long shadow into the future. Most infrastructure is built to last for decades. However, over the infrastructure lifespan, demography, economic structure, user demands, and societal priorities will change, and new technologies will come to the fore. That is why flexibility is crucial, and why it is important to think about the flexibility that will be needed when making the investment decision. This subject area is also known as strategic asset management. Then, second, the role of infrastructure intelligence that is provided by the invasion of information technology and telecommunication infrastructure in all infrastructure sectors. What is the potential of this intelligence for better infrastructure services? And what are the new risks and vulnerabilities thus created? Cybersecurity is obviously one of the special topics in this module. Then, third, the theme of smart electricity grids. This is a special case of an intelligent infrastructure network, where we see electricity infrastructure being interconnected with information technology and telecoms infrastructure, as well as with transportation infrastructure. A major challenge here is to balance the intermittency of renewable energy resources, such as wind and photovoltaic solar panels, with flexible electricity demand, for example, through controlled recharging of the batteries of electric vehicles. And then, fourth, there is the theme of eco-cities. Here we focus on a higher level of aggregation, viewing cities as nodes in a system of multiple interacting infrastructure systems. Mind you, by 2050, more than two-thirds of the world's population will live in cities. As an example, in China, 1 billion people will live in cities by 2030. In the development of eco-cities, green cities, low-carbon cities, and the like, urban infrastructure design is key, and we will review examples of more and less successful eco-city development from around the globe. And this selection of themes, those four themes, is inspired by the questions we received from the participants during part one of this course. So, the course starts with a short recap of NGI part one to give you sufficient background for part two. All course materials of part one will be available to you. So, we are thrilled to welcome you to part two of Next Generation Infrastructures, and we hope that you are prepared for the challenge of rethinking the concept of infrastructure systems. You are bound to learn to embrace complexity. So, join us in our quest for future-proof infrastructures, and do enjoy the learning experience. Thank you.